Carrie Obedzinski, Times Business Development Manager. Welcome to Real Times, our vlog where we'll talk about industry trends, new products, meet some experts, and talk all things coax. Today's episode is with Tony Fedor. He's our product manager for cable, and he's been with us for 30 years, right, Tony? Mm-hmm.
Long time.
So you're definitely one of the experts. We're going to talk about a new product today. So what do you have there?
This in my hand here is our half-inch, new half-inch plenum cable. It's a corrugated copper design with a highly flame-retardant, low-smoke PVC outer jacketing. And this cable is qualified to type CMP listing, which CM in the National Electric Code stands for communications cable and P for plenum. Any cable that's used up in an air return handling section of a building needs to meet plenum requirements per the National Electric Code and the National Fire Protection Agency. So we've designed a very somewhat flexible cable, not quite as flexible as our standard LMR, but it's a half inch backbone plenum rated coax cable.
So you lightly touched on this, but where would you use this cable?
Generally, these are used up in air return handling plenums. In most building applications, a lot of the cable is run in the raceways where air return handling ducts, because it's a nice, easy way to lay cables. What they found over the years, though, is in the event of a fire, the air return handling duct acts as a big billow and sends smoke and flame racing through a building, which is obviously a big concern. So the way the building codes are written today is if you're going to put any cable in an air return handling duct, it has to meet a very stringent flame and smoke performance test. It's basically called the UL910, or they called it the Steiner tunnel test. Very severe flame and smoke test.
Is that why it's red?
No, actually we have it red because a lot of the public safety DAS systems, police and fire, a lot of the stuff they're using is for red. They want to have red jacketed cable, red boxes. It's just an identifier. And we're seeing a lot of applications in 700 megahertz interoperability for public safety right now. And this is a good solid half-inch feeder line to feed the more flexible coaxes that we also have plenum listed as well.
And where could you find some more information out about this plenum cable?
On our website. We have a lot of information on our website. We have some new product releases that we just came out with and some information sheets as well. So reach out to your local rep or come just to the website and go to tech questions or sales inquiries, I guess.
Yeah, all of the above.
One or the other, it'll get to somebody and we'll address it.
Well, thank you for joining us today, Tony. I appreciate it. This is Real Times, your place to meet experts like Tony, talk about new products like our plenum cable, and talk about all things RF. If you have additional questions, you can ask them below, or you can email us at realtimes@timesmicro.com. That's R-E-E-L. And if you enjoyed this video, please share it and like it. Until next time, stay healthy, and thanks for watching.